హాయ్ యోయో వ్యూవర్స్, సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసేటప్పుడు అక్కడ ఉండే గంట సింబల్ ను ప్రెస్ చేయడం మర్చిపోవద్దు.
గరుడ ఎక్స్ప్రెస్, an international courier service. Hi, hello and welcome to YoYo TV Chit Chat with me, Sheena Saluja, where in studio we have with us the D16 or 16 movies hero and director. So let me tell you the hero of the movie, Sir Rehman, also known as Raghu in the Tollywood industry, and the director of the movie, Karthik. And let me precise on the age of the director, which is just 22 years old. So let's find out more about the movie and their future projects.
I still don't get this. Okay, Rozu, okay, missing case? Yeah, to begin with. And cold-blooded murder. Cold? I don't think so. And one planned accident. Maybe. Idantha okay spot lo jariginda? దీనిలో ఎంతమంది ఇన్వాల్వ్ అయ్యారు? 16. ఇదంతా జరగడానికి ఎంత టైం పట్టింది? 16 అవర్స్. ఫ్రీకీ కోయిన్సిడెన్స్. ప్రతి హత్యకు ప్రత్యేకమైన కారణాలుండవు.
మీరు ఇస్తున్న హింట్ని బట్టి చూస్తే మనం ఒక సైకో కిల్లర్ని చేస్ చేస్తున్నట్టు అనిపిస్తుంది సార్.
ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ. హూ నోస్.
హలో, రిమెంబర్ మీ? Let me give you a clue, a simple one. Baga alochinchi cheppandi. Ippudu meer cheppina vaatiki nene kaaranam. You can call me a psychopath, serial killer, murderer, sadist. Yamenarku, but nenu ivanni cheyadaniki oka kaaranam undi. Kaalam mundu evaraina sare talavanchalsinde, adi nene. మీరు నన్ను వెతుక్కుంటూ రావాల్సిన అవసరమే లేదు. ఎదురు పడ్డా నన్ను గుర్తుపట్టలేరు. అయినా కూడా మీరు ప్రయత్నిస్తే ఐ విల్ కిల్ యు బ్రూటల్లీ. ఇంకా కనిపెట్టలేదా? గుడ్, థింక్, కీప్ థింకింగ్, బట్ యు నో ద ఆన్సర్ రైట్? హూ యామ్ ఐ?
You'll be needing this.
So yes, firstly, a huge congratulations to Rehman sir and Karthik. It's been amazing in Tamil. It's coming like huge response coming in for Dhruvanga Pattinaru, if I'm not pronouncing it wrong. It's going amazing. So Telugu, it's releasing tomorrow. How is it all about? How do you feel about it?
Very excited, very excited. Especially in Telugu, it is titled Padiharu, 16, every detail counts. And I wish not only in Andhra, Telangana or anywhere, I wish this movie to go all around the world, even in Bollywood or Hollywood, and because this movie is a special movie, not only for the director but for me too.
Yes. Karthik, such young age, 23, 24 I guess?
22 now.
22, yeah. Oh God. First movie.
I was 21 when I made the film actually.
Yeah, yeah. So we would count that as 21 I guess.
Okay.
So 21, movie going so amazing, a thriller I would tell. How do you feel about it?
Actually, this is kind of scary, you know, because before the film's release, people, they didn't have any preoccupied notion about the director of the movie. But after the film's release, I think since it has become a very big hit in Tamil Nadu, there are a lot of expectations for our next project. And I think, you know, we have to satisfy them. And
exactly.
I consider that as a responsibility. Yeah.
So coming to Telugu, which is being released tomorrow, D16 it is being titled. So
16.
Yeah.
Just 16.
16.
It's just 16.
Yeah.
Okay. So 16. So the D is coming in, like we see the trailer and by it, it is like 16 days, 16 hours and 16 people involved. So how is it all about? Just give a gist about how is it?
Well, you got to ask the writer of it.
Now, the film involves 16 characters and it's the narration of 16 hours. It's not 16 days, it's the narration of 16 hours.
Okay.
And actually, we titled the Tamil version as D16.
Okay.
D means Dhruvangal as well as Sir's character name is Deepak. So, it's like, you know, short form of that, D16. And I think the entire plot revolves around his character. You know, it's the redemption of a wounded soul. If you ask me, I'll put the one line of the movie through this. It's the redemption of a wounded soul.
We can't
reveal anything more than that as of now.
The original title, as like you said, mentioned before, Dhruvangal Padinar, that means it's like extremes, has a lot of poetic and novelistic thought put into it. Because just putting a title nowadays in most of the films, the title is something and the film story is basically something. But this is the proper title for this. But
totally
it's not just not an ordinary title. The meaning of it itself shows in another dimension. It's like extremes of your, like he had told before,
human
emotions.
So, Karthik, this question is like fired on you. So, is it like a real story you've heard or read or anything? Or it's like, to be precise, it's a real story or a real story? What is it?
You know, partly real and partly real.
That's
how I work, because the working style of every writer, it differs. You know, few writers, they prefer to watch a lot of movies, and few writers, they read a lot of books.
Exactly.
And, you know, obviously I watch a lot of movies, but to be very honest, I don't read a lot of books. But I meet a lot of people, you know, I have conversation with them so that I can get to know about their life, about their backstories and all. I personally believe that having the conversation with somebody is equal to reading 1,000 books.
True.
So with that being said, I meet a lot of people and I, you know, get stuff from their life and I incorporate it in my film.
So, like, writing the script and everything, did you have sir in mind? Did you have Raghu sir, if I would tell
Rahman,
the Telugu, how you're famous in the Telugu industry as Mr. Raghu and Raghuram?
Rahman, Raghu or Rahman?
Raghu or Rahman, to be precise. So, did you have sir in your mind or did the character demand his, his role and physique in that?
Okay, when I wrote the script, I didn't have anybody in mind. But after writing the script, I think the character chose Rahman sir.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of telling that I chose Rahman sir, I think the character chose Rahman sir. Because the character of Deepak, it's like it has to underplay throughout the entire film. And you know, over dramatizing something or emoting is very easy compared to underplaying. And I think Rahman sir does that with ease. You know, he's effortless when it comes to acting. So that's why I just approached him and he, you know, kind of realized the potential of the script and he said yes.
Coming back to you, sir, it's like a comeback for you coming in the lead back in the movies. So, how did you choose the script? What was more attracting in the script that you chose it?
Yeah, it's been a while since I got such a heavy character to play as the lead and things, because of lately, I've been, my characters have not been this meaty enough.
Exactly.
Due to circumstances. And but if you look at my body of work, I've been always been choosy. Whatever characters I did, I never tried to, you know, repeat it. Sometimes only the characters that I repeated was being a cop in most of the movies, the few of the movies that I've done. But it had a different kind of storytelling in that, or the content was different. And I basically, when I started with this film, it was just an actor myself doing this particular character called Deepak. That's all about it. I was not thinking of, you know, targeting and making it, my comeback film or my, going to be 100 days. I will see to that. Planned everything. Nothing like that. I never planned anything of this one. I just did it as an actor, got something, and I tried to justify it. I only felt the realization is when I saw the movie personally. That's when everything hit on my face.
So your character with the trailer, I see you can call me a murderer, psychopath, a sadist or something like that. So tell us about your character Deepak in the movie.
He's a cop, naturally cop investigates, and the beauty about is I can only talk about what I was doing, how my style of from the rest of the cop stories that I have did. In this movie, I think we have brought not only on the technical side, but even on the directors chosen to be actors. You know, all the actors have gone into another higher level of acting. You know, trying to bring the subtlety on all the actors, be it not only me, even the new faces. Everybody is new in this movie, other than me. So we saw to that. You know, it's very original, very realistic. At the same time, it's not an art film or it's not a class film.
Exactly.
It is a mass film. Which, like one director, famous director also said that this movie has broken all the rules of filmmaking. So you will not see the usual conventional type of police story in this movie. You will feel as if you are in a real situation.
Yeah, we could see that through the trailer. It was like I was, you know, jumping off my seat. Like, how is it? What's happening? What is happening? Like, that was the whole thing, what I was facing.
And this, in my, I can only talk about the acting that I did or the body language I did. Because he, first of all, he mentioned me. So, we want a cop who's like, you know, like they say the boy next door or the girl next door or whatever. So, it's like a cop, the next door cop. The normal cop that you see, not the filmy Singham kind of cops or any other. When you wear your dress and you're rigid and your sharp turns and, you know, dialogue delivery and punch delivery. And we cut off all those things because in real life, you don't see all these kind of stupid things. So, we brought down that into incorporate what he wanted and what is written on the script. I was to have to incorporate that, you know, like to bring that fine, thin line of balance. So, when you're trying to do such kind of acting, it's even more tougher. You can be exaggerated in front of camera. Everyone intend to become exaggerated. You have to cut down that process. So, making it live and making it lively.
How much could you connect to the, you know, your character?
In all my movies, whenever I do anything, I fall into that character somehow within the second day or the third day. If my director is good enough to understand me or if he has the brains to, you know, convince me, then I get into the character. And I'm very passionate about my career and I'm very passionate about acting. So
your first movie working with such a huge star, I would tell. So how was it all about? Were you like, work has to be done, or you were like a chilled out, yeah, these stars are there, my work will be done? How were you as a director on the sets?
I think you define the qualities of a director very well, because a director should have both these qualities.
Exactly.
You know? He has to be adamant to some extent so that he has to get his work done. At the same time, he should not panic, he has to be chilled out regarding his work. Because the moment I start to panic, I think the work falls flat. You know, everything goes haywire and I can't do anything about it. And working with Ram Mansoor, it was like, initially for the first 2 or 3 days, I was kind of scared, you know, asking him for one more, because his experience is greater than my age. He's having 32 years of experience in cinema. So asking one more from such an artist, it was like, you know, a bit of a concern for me. But I think after 2 or 3 days, we got used to it, you know, we were on the same page.
So you told there are 16 more characters and different people in the, so tell us about them. How is it?
I think because of the genre, we can't reveal anything. It's experience best without knowing anything.
So, sir, making a mark in Tamil, Malayalam, Telugu, in all industry, making your foot so firm. Where do you find that comfort zone in these three genres?
I find that comfort zone with the character and the director that I'm working with at that time. I love brainy directors or with some sensible directors who has some common sense, not living with I've worked with others also with the flukes of success and, you know, the luck of success. But when you really get to know, there are few people you think they have done 2-3 films with a lot of success,
exactly.
And but when you know that they're not brainy enough, it's all just happened sheer luck. So that is very disappointing, and I'm very like attracted to people who have common senses. I'm talking about directors who are sensible enough. So that's my comfort zone.
So connecting to the your answer, defining Karthik, how do you define him as a director?
I need not say that, because the success itself proves it.
Exactly.
Yes, it is because when this movie started off, is through the narration, he trying to convince me, and I refused it. The first time, I refused this movie. I will not do it, because when he said I'm doing a cop role, I just did this like this. Then the second time he made me listen to the story. He was very adamant that I should listen to the story, and very adamant that I have to do this by any cost. Otherwise, he said he will just not ever do it or not ever approach this subject ever. He started, you know, that's how they do talk. But for me, I started liking it and I loved the screenplay. And the screenplay, I had to keep on hearing it a couple of times, because according to me, it hit my ego. Is most of the films that I have worked with, within one or two sittings, I understand the whole concept of the story and my character and everything. But for him, I had to sit at least like 10 times. And that hit me, because he kept narrating. See, visual treat is different, and narrating this kind of genre is very difficult.
Exactly.
I cannot do that. And he keeps telling, and he's a bit fast, and then he talk, blah, 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 blah. Then again, stops, let me come back, rewind, talk, you know, like that. So that hit my ego, and then that was like, you know, that brainy thing, it works in your mind. So these were the few reasons how I started doing the film. because I have not heard an interesting screenplay like this before till now. To all the 200 films that I have done so far, I have not heard, you know, fantastic screenplay it was. So these were the things, little things that got me into this movie. But at the same time, I was scared about it because he had no earlier experience in movie making. He promised me within 28 days he will finish this film. I just laughed like that because I heard bigger directors saying, whatever date they say, it always takes more than
extended.
That.
Extended.
Mm-hmm. Extended. And we had three different locations to move from Chennai to Coimbatore and to Coimbatore to Ooty. And then he's saying 28 days, how is it possible? And so many scenes, and this is a brainy scenes, and dialogues are there, movements are there. What are you going to do? But they had planned out everything, and they were all this young team from his age to the youngest person in the whole team was him.
Yeah.
And the whole group in things. So, and then, yeah, giving a responsibility on his shoulder was for my decision. Should I or should I not? And his father was the producer, finally. And then I could find there was something, you know, some things are, you know, made from heaven, like blessing, like he was behind me to do this. And yes, then I walked into that, and within the second day itself, I knew his caliber on the sets, because I was relaxed, like I didn't have to put anything, I just have to sit there and wait for my shot to come and do my work, that's it.
Yeah. So is it true, like it took only 28 days? How did the whole planning and everything go on with you?
Actually, we got just 20 days for pre-production for the entire film. If given a chance, I would have done more than that, but we just got 20 days. And regarding the planning, I think I was clear with the entire film in my mind, because once you are clear with that, you can break down everything to your comfort zone. So I think that's how we were. And regarding the 28 days, I just told Rahman sir that, sir, I'll start the film on September 25th and we'll wrap it up on November 1st. And that was a huge risk we took because we shot during rainy season. So if it had rained for one day during shoot, then the entire schedule would have like collapsed.
Postponed, yeah.
Because working on a very low budget, that too, made in production house, we can't afford, you know, a lot of schedule changes. We can't afford to send people off every time, you know, saying there is no shoot because of rain. Mm-hmm. So I think when you really want something, the universe cooperates, right? That is exactly what happened. I think because of Rahman's cooperation and everything fell in place, we were able to, you know, finish it off in 28 days.
So Rahman sir, before we move on a little bit from the movie, mm-hmm. I would request you, like, I've seen the trailer personally and I loved it, no doubt. So I would like want to have a personal dialogue of yours from the movie, anything of your choice for sure. So in that character, in the mood and everything, so you can give a short, like, yeah, take on.
No, Rahman sir's favorite dialogue in the movie, but unfortunately we can't reveal it now.
Yeah, but I can say freaky
coincidence.
Yeah, I've seen that. That's so really like freaky coincidence. I was like, ah, that's nice. I loved it like completely, yeah. No doubt. So, sir, being born in Dubai, if I'm not wrong, and now living in Kerala, and now in, you know,
Chennai,
working in Hyderabad, living in Chennai and working in Hyderabad, which is the more preferred city and the country you would always be there?
Overall, India is my favorite country. I've traveled all over the world. But the freedom I get, or I think I feel India is the best place, and especially South India. And Chennai, I'm used to it more than my native. I'm used to it, and I love Chennai. And I love Hyderabad, because Hyderabad has good eat-outs.
That's what it's like. Everyone, if I ask, Hyderabad is like most famous for food,
yeah,
no
food,
doubt.
Yeah.
So what is your special thing which you love in Hyderabad?
I love all the good food. I love basically food, and food is something interesting, right? Even on TV or channels you watch, anything that is connected to food, you just stop and keep looking.
Yeah. So you are a big biryani person, if I would be precise?
Yeah, I love biryani, I love parathas, I love everything, vegetarian, non-vegetarian, anything doesn't matter.
Yes. So
yeah.
Do you keep your hand in cooking anytime?
Yes, I used to cook before marriage, as a bachelor. But yeah, I do good cook. I mean, I cook somewhere. I cook biryani and things like that.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. I love it. Now my wife doesn't allow me to come inside.
Coming on to your family, sir,
yeah.
You have two kids. Tell us about them.
Yeah, well, I'm blessed with two angels, two girls. And one is, they both are the same age. So it's for me, like, you know, after the movie, every time I just come home and relax and I look at my daughter, she keeps telling something to me. I say, hey, you don't anything, sit down. And then again, the next day morning, I put up on my makeup and go to the set. Yes, sir. No, sir. Okay, sir. The same 21-year-old, you know, I'm looking this side. When I'm saying you don't know anything, you sit down. And when I have to listen. So this is my, you know, I used to sit back and think about all that.
So are they all set to get in your industry, if I would tell? Are they interested in it?
Well, my elder girl shows interest, but I want to, you know, have education to be completed. I don't know what's, you know, written on our head.
Yeah. So do you all, like family, obviously, do you all sit back, see your movies, and how is the whole, you know, comparison? Dad, you must have done that. And
yeah, my
that
elder one is more, she's more observant in movies. She has my passion of how watching movies and things like that, mostly Indian movies. And she observes the screen, the script, screenplay, dialogues, everything. And she hasn't gone to any classes or something, but she keeps telling me the wrong and the right and all that stuff about other actors, about me and everything. And somewhere what she says is also is my view,
exactly.
Opinion. So she's not like a immature. She knows what she's talking about. So she gives comments about every movie, and especially this movie. And she cried after seeing the movie in the end.
Yeah, so she was always on the sets?
No. She doesn't come onto the set, nothing. Because I don't want them to get distracted between their studies. So, but then they observe the movie a lot. Yeah.
So coming to you, Karthik, tell us about your life, your education. How was it all about?
I think I can tell about my life, you know, rather than my education, because I discontinued when I was in the third year of engineering.
Okay.
I think regarding my life, I'm yet to explore life. I'm just 22, you know, I've just stepped into the world of filmmaking, so I'm yet to explore life. But as far as I know, life is very interesting and it's beautiful, you know, just like the film, it's like unpredictable. You can't predict what's going to happen next for you. I think I just take it as it comes.
So it's like from engineering coming into filmmaking, that's like a totally kind of a different field.
Yeah.
So how did it all come up to you? Like, were you interested?
I started making short films when I was in the first year. Okay. So till that point, I didn't have any clarity or idea in mind regarding what I'm going to do for the rest of my life or what is my career going to be. I had like no idea about that till I joined engineering college. But after I started making short films, that is when I decided no matter how hard or, you know, the level of struggles I'm going to face, filmmaking is where I belong, and this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life.
So
and because the moment I took up the, you know, topic of filmmaking, people tend to feed a negativity to you.
True.
They are like, the success ratio in filmmaking is very low and it's not for everyone. I just told them, see, it's my life and I know my decision.
So your parents were supportive about this always?
They were very supportive, or else, you know, this film wouldn't have happened in the first place.
True.
My father and mother, they belong in the education line actually. My father, he works for the disabled people, and my mom is a chemistry lecturer back at a college called Avinash Lingam at Coimbatore. So I think if it was a normal household, their son coming and telling them that he wants to venture into filmmaking would have created a very big chaos in the household, you know, because we know about the mindset of father and mother. But still, end of the day, they just told me that, see, this is your life and this is your career. We can only advise about that. We don't want to, you know, intrude in that. So it's your call and you can go ahead.
So your parents, belonging to education background, mm-hmm. they didn't ever come up to you like, you're not dropping your studies or do whatever. They didn't, mm-hmm. you know, have any.
Yeah, they advised
it.
Me. It was not like, you know, they care, you hold my hand and they didn't let it go. It's not kind of like that. They advised me regarding, you know, it's your life, it's your decision. So think twice before you make the final call, because once you discontinue, you can't go back once again and you won't have a degree. So that was their advice. After thinking for a long time, I just kind of felt that I was being alienated in engineering college, you know. I didn't feel that I belonged here. So that is why I took that decision, and they were okay with it. Actually.
So you were all said that, yaar, mujhe toh chhodna hi hai engineering. You were all set about that.
Yeah. Actually, that's what I
did. See, even about the producer, this sheer example, like your question stated, saying that didn't your parents stop
exactly.
you from... And what he said also was there, because not all parents are like that, you know, telling a child, live your dreams. But of course, I know them personally and they were educated. They'll tell you the mistakes and everything. But the real simple fact is, when he was struggling in the industry to get a producer, and when he couldn't, he almost like went down and he just spoke to his dad casually. That's a don't worry. Tell me how much it is. I'll
do
it. They're not financially sound.
That's like, that totally puts a full stop to my question that they were like 110% in support with you and with the movie.
Yeah.
The father, it's not for the movie, but for the son. Father gifted, I mean, father did something for the son.
I think it's his blessing, you know, because he didn't ask me the one line, the title about the movie, what is the script, screenplay, nothing. He just told me, give me a rough budget and you start working.
Just
on
a blind
film.
Faith,
yeah, was,
I
yeah.
would tell.
Exactly, yeah.
So, Karthik, it's like whenever you start a new project, this is obviously a new field where you were stepping in. So, did you have that scary moment, the nervousness working with such a big star? And, you know, the whole thing, did I do something wrong or something? You were clear with the script, no doubt. But, you know, the thing of having a success and this, you know, a fall, it's very thin.
It's a very thin line in
filmmaking, no doubt. So how did you cope up with that? Did you ever feel, yaar, I should have been in engineering only?
No,
did
not
you ever
even
come
a
back?
Single time. No, I never regretted that decision. But yeah, of course, I felt kind of scared and nervous a lot of times, but I never doubted my own decision. Because the moment you start to doubt your own decision, that is when everything, you know, it will be like you will start to have doubts about yourself. So when you have that in mind, it's like very difficult for you to cope up with your work. So I was kind of scared when approaching him, and I was kind of scared while directing him for the couple of days. And I think you have to, this all comes with the part of, you know, our job, you know, being a director, it requires a lot of patience. So I think it comes with that.
I think that is the whole mindset because of which you are in such young age. No doubt, age is no bar nowadays.
We see so
much of talent now. But I think that is the whole, you know, mindset because of which you're seeing such huge success. Many more congratulations to you both for
amazing job.
Sir, tell us, when are we, like, about your future, you know, projects? How is it all?
Your future projects, after this success, obviously, I've a lot of movies have been spoken about and talked for, and the storytellings are going on. There is one in Telugu that I am discussing about. So once that gets concrete, I normally don't like to talk before the chickens are hatched, you know. So.
So it's like always we've been seeing you excelling in negative roles more
yeah.
often, which I would tell. So is it coming up like the next roles also? Is it
something
like that?
No. I can't do that. I can't do a negative schedule because it's not because I just got here into this role. It's not like that. Sometimes if the role demands, it's not that I will do the hero roles hereafter because I've got this beautiful success on my head and I got to live up to it. And if I have to live up to it, I have to stand in the industry and the people ask to like, they expect from me, there is a crowd that expects from me such kind of films. And
sure.
Maybe I've just made a new road for that, for some film, serious film goers or something like that. No? In being in my status or in being my experience, so I can take a movie to another level. That's what I think I will do in the future, trying to do something different. And of course, it's not the hero something. My hero will always be the script and screenplay. So that's the hero, especially this movie is also like that. It's try to give more importance to the content.
So it's always
and moreover, jokingly, yeah. I'm happier now is because more than the success is my little girl got to see me as a hero in a movie.
Yeah, that's actually a
because yeah, my elder one knows, but the second one always felt, why are you always, you know, like a bad man in the movie and things like that. When she feels, you know, shy to tell friends and all that stuff. Why? You just say, I'm an actor. Actor will be good, but we are just acting.
So she was the happiest person to
see
the movie.
She's more proud,
So tell us, Karthik, facing huge success, no doubt, once again, I tell that. So what is your coming up projects? Are you planned with stuff?
Yeah, it is on flows, and I would like to take, you know, one step at a time. That is how I approach filmmaking. So next film, it is produced by Gautam Menon sir, and regarding the cast, we are in talks. You know, we'll announce it officially after everything goes on paper.
So sir, would you, you know, if the, obviously it's the script what demands and not the director, as you told. So would
no,
you
the director also do be them.
It also?
Yeah.
Yes.
The director should have some brains.
Yeah, common sense. I would quote that. But
brains.
Brains. Okay. So would you, like, if the script and the director you have worked with, would you mind working with Karthik, or you would be like, oh,
definitely,
yes?
Definitely. Why not? Definitely. I would love to if I feel if the character is good enough and things like that. Of course, his talents I know. His ability I know. And I don't have to think about it again. Not like how I sat in the first place.
So being in the industry for so long, sir, I wouldn't even quote the years because it's uncountable, kind of. So now you were waiting to play a hero, a lead. So what is else more, like, you have a, I wouldn't quote it as a dream role, but a thing you want to do, a role?
This question I've been asked all my life, and I don't know, is it my problem? I don't know. I never had this having a dream role or the roles that I wish to do or want to do, I never had that in mind. I know for most of the actors they have it, but I don't know, I've been hearing it all my years. I still not have found it. I want to do movies, I like to do characters, and it should challenge me in some way or the other, and that's it. I never have something. The character that I did in this movie, or the way that I portrayed my character in this movie, is, and I'm awesomed about it. I am dumbstruck about what I did in the movie. It's gone to that power level. Maybe if you ask me, can you rework this again? Then I don't think so. I can. It just happened.
So do you like take up the experiment thing, or you plan to play it safe with the roles when it comes up?
Plan to play it safe. Experimental, yes, it will come automatically. But whatever it is, you've got to, I can't be very artistic because I know I'm doing a cinema. It's not for, it's an entertainment business. So there is a little of that artificiality also in it. So it's just how you, balance both. I'm talking about only in acting wise. I'm not talking about the character or whatever it is. So I try to bring that fine line in between them both. So that's how I go about it. And I'm also happy, I feel that after this success of this movie all over the South India itself, people are slowly yes, of course, they are accepting good movies. There are other good movies, so many good parallel cinemas, like what they call, which has been run. But it now it's changing. There is a change, and I'm happy that youngsters like Karthik and many of them he has opened the doors for many of them, like things like that. And I'm happy that they could recognize my talents and come to me or actors like me in today's generation. So yeah, I'm in that 21-year-old generation.
No doubt, sir. D16 or 16, I would quote it as. Releasing this Friday, why do you want us to see the movie? I love the trailer and I'm waiting for it to see, but in your words, why do you
want
the audience
to see? In my opinion,
in
my way, you can see the movie not only for me, or not only just a 21-year-old boy Karthik Narayan has directed, but otherwise you will have a better experience when you go to see particularly this movie in the theater, because it is a movie to be watched in the theater. It has an experience to be watched in the theater.
Exactly.
It's not only just the story and the thing. There's so many other 24 crafts that has worked into this movie. Making a movie, you need this 24 crafts. Most of them don't use the rest 20 crafts in it, or it just maybe it's only there in the title. But he has given all the importance of what a real movie should feel like, sound like, look like, and being showcased like. That's how it should be. That's how we appreciate the Hollywood movies. It's definitely it's like that. This is not any nativity kind of movie, anything. It's so for all the new aspiring young talents out there, for them it'll be worth it to watch this movie. It can be an inspirational learning, something like, in today's generation or today's time of the world, like these movies can be made here, or this kind of things can be done. They will have an inspiration how to go about the script, how to go about the screenplay, how to go about the editing, all that. And there's a little, you can get inspired from this. So for all the aspiring people, I'm saying, for others, this will be a totally full-on entertainment film. It has broken all the records of movie making, like I said earlier. And there will not be, you will not have time to go to the washroom, nor go buy a popcorn. That's
like
the beauty about it.
You just have to catch his teeth and just sit there for
it's like you normally say, you make sit edge of the seat. You see edge of the seat only in horror movies, like
exactly.
They're stuck, but they're not thinking. But this one, edge of the seat means you are interacting. This movie also interacts with the audience.
So it's like brainstorming all the time.
Yeah,
you
will be talking. You will be talking to your friend, and you will be a detective, or you will be somebody inside one of the characters. So it's more like an interaction film.
So not missing on the topic which sir told, the music and the sound effects, the editing. Was it a hard time for you to get, your people and the technicians, and how did it all go about?
I contacted everyone through FB. It was not very hard to get them together, because my editor and cinematographer, they are brothers, Suchit Sarang and Srijit Sarang, and I met my music director through my editor, Srijit Sarang. So it was not that difficult to form a proper team.
It wasn't.
No, it wasn't, yeah.
So it's I would tell a luck and your efforts, for no doubt, your efforts, your struggle.
Yeah,
and
it is. Yeah, you know, cinema is all about destiny. You have to be at the right place and right time. You know, no matter how much of talent you have and how much passion towards filmmaking you have, still cinema, it has to cooperate. You have to be at the right time and at the right place. I think that's what happened with
And one more thing, like I said, you know, it's a theatre experience in all the sound and everything. Please don't misunderstand me. This is not a Jurassic film or Jurassic Park kind of film where you have dinosaurs walking. Nothing of that sort. It's just a normal making movie, but there are so many beautiful things that
is
happening.
Cinematic experience, it can be experienced best in theatres.
So you don't take away the movie visual, you take experience with you.
Exactly.
In a normal film. So with the way I said it, people who's watching this might find that, oh, is it a Jurassic Park or a, you know, King Kong film or anything.
The storytelling experience will be complete in theatres.
Okay. So what would be your take on why should the audience be stressed on watching this movie?
According to me, I think filmmaking is all about communication between a filmmaker and the audience. Me narrating a story to the audience. So people, if they want to listen to a very good story, you know, I won't call it as watching a film. If they want to listen to a very good story, I think they can come to 16 Every Detail Counts. And definitely, the story won't disappoint them.
So you are such a young person and you've already been an inspiration for many of us and many of the audience for sure. So what would you tell the, you know, young generation or your generation too? So how to like go ahead with your dreams? Like you have gone with your dreams and you have successfully fulfilled your dream. It's just a start, no doubt. But how would you quote it as?
I think instead of calling it an advice, I can put it like sharing my experience to them. If you have something in your mind regarding this is what I want to do, then please don't change from that. You know, your conviction, it has to be very strong, because the moment you take an offbeat topic like cinema, people, not just cinema, the moment you take something which people don't prefer a lot, then automatically a lot of negativity will be around it. You know, people will say, this is not for you, it's not as easy as you think it is. So you should not listen to all that. You know, if you are clear with your goal and your destination, you just have to keep moving forward. You have to ignore all the negativity and negative people around you. That's it.
Exactly. I think that is the most important thing.
Yeah, that's the most important thing. Yeah. We shouldn't let other things influence your mind and your decision. Yeah.
So what would be your say about this, sir?
Well, I don't know. I'm not a good judge in saying why to see this movie or not to see the movie, anything. For me, every movie matters. Even if I'm not acting, if I'm watching it also, it should be of some reason. So the story must be there. There should be something different in the movie that I see. So for me, that all matters. When I'm watching a movie, I'm just like any other normal audience. So it should you know, connect with me or somewhere, something, or it should satisfy me. So I think those will be some sensible films only.
So yes, it has been amazing to know so much about the movie, which I haven't, waiting to watch the movie. Mm-hmm. And you have been very much, you know, on your seats, like not revealing anything about the movie in spite of me trying to. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So please tell us, when is the movie releasing?
This movie is releasing on March 10th in the whole of Andhra and Telangana. And it's dubbed into Telugu as well as in Tamil. It is
also,
we have Tamil version and the Telugu version. And this movie is also simultaneously releasing in Kerala in Tamil version. It is already running in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. It is crossed 11th of Monday, it's crossing 75 days. And that had just in many theaters, not one theater, like most of the superstar films. It is running in 30 theaters because running successfully. I have to boast about it because it's really been an honest, successful film. I underline honest, successful film.
So yes, thank you so much, Raghu sir, I would tell, and Karthik.
Thank you, Sheena.
By conclusion, I would only say is book your tickets online or anywhere and get your tickets, because it is for sure going to be house full. Because right now what I'm going to do is book my ticket to see the thriller of what happens in the 16 hours of that episode of the movie. So find out more about this only on YoYo TV. This is Sheena Saluja signing off.
Hi, this is Rahman. Like, share and subscribe. This is YoYo TV. All the updates you want to know, watch YoYo TV.
Hi everyone, this is Karthik Narain, director of 16, aka 16. So like, comment and share YoYo TV to know all the latest updates about films.